Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining the 2012 North American Shuffleboard Championships. Here, Bob Perry is about to shoot his final weight of the frame. And he sticks it. Leaving Craig White with his final weight of the frame. And he's having to make a decision on just where to put his lag. Looks like he has more room coming from the right-hand side of the board. His right. Going to that big open hole on the left side. Will he make it? Lag off. And Bob Perry is going to play this frame short. Just past the foul line. Craig will say, I'll just stick you right back there, Bob, and put another short one up. And this is an interesting way to approach the game here, because Bob is essentially trying to keep Craig from feeling the end of the board, so he's making him continually have to shoot at these short weights and not allowing his right hand or his left hand to feel what a two or a three feels like, or even read down the board how the board breaks. It's a pretty good strategy early in the game to keep the person with the hammer guessing all the time. Bob puts a big fat one down there. Craig will get a feel on this one. Looks like he's going right to it. Like a backboard. Bob probably just stick him right back. Notice the dexterity these guys have with both hands. They can easily shoot right-handed or left-handed. Now Craig's got to make a decision here. Is he going to try to stick that one, or is he going to try to outlag it, or maybe put a roll on it and go to a three? Looks like he rolled it to a two. Craig says, if you want to play me short, then I'll play you short. Coming right back to him. Bob hits it on the side of the weight. Craig might put this short, but a little bit different spot. Bob doesn't have the same shot at two angles at a row. Now it looks like Bob's intentionally bumping him up here to create some interference and potentially create a pretty big frame for himself to get back in the game fast. Craig might use this to pass, use the interference for his own good, and Bob might be in a fair bit of trouble. Looks like he executed a beautiful go-around right there on the two line. Bob's got to try to combo these off here. Misses his combo, but he kept his other one working. Bob has last weight on this frame. And I think he's going for the lag. And lags off. That was a 3-point conversion there. Craig ended up getting 3 points there without the hammer. That's very, very big frame for Craig. looks like Bob's got himself in another pickle here where he's playing with his weight behind. Craig's got two on the board. It's a lot of interference. Some guys like to play with a lot of weights on the board. Some guys like to play more conservatively. Now Bob's going to go ahead and stick that one up. Nice shot. Very nice shot. What's Bob gonna do here? Try to stick up that blue one. He'll have two on the board. And then if Craig goes past him, he just sticks him for three. I think that's the right shot. That's what he does there. Sticks it right up. No problem for Bob Perry, Hall of Fame shuffleboard player. Bob was actually just inducted last year into the National Hall of Fame. He's been playing for several years, and he has a son, Tim Perry, who's no slouch himself. Up-and-coming pro, Tim Perry. Both him and his dad are fantastic. Fantastic shuffleboard players, and good people, too. Some of the nicest people you'll ever meet. Bob's getting ready for his lag here. He's got one working, so he's in a great position. If he can get a two or a three down there, he gets right back in this game. That looks pretty good. All right, 4-7. Craig White in the lead. Bob's first weight down there. Up, nice and tight up against the rail. Craig sticks it. Here comes Bob firing back. Third weight. Hits it off. Clean board's a good board, that's what they say. Craig plays a short weight to protect his hammer. Bob will try to stick that like a pro. Now Craig's lagging. Now he's on 7 here with a 3-point lead. He could really put the hurt on Bob here. Last time he lagged, from this end, I believe he lagged off. He said, I'm not going to lag off this time. Now the score is 4-8, and Craig delivers his first weight. Decided to go all the way off the end of the board. Now that was on purpose, because he doesn't want to give Bob anything to go around here. Doesn't want to give him any play at all. I'm sure he learned that from playing against Mike Taylor. Now Bob sets up on an area where he thinks that if Craig accidentally sticks this weight, Bob will be able to go right around it. Craig hits it just right on the side of the weight, keeping the board clear, not allowing Bob Perry to go around, hide, or play with him in any way. Sometimes the best way to play a pro is just to go weight for weight and try to make him lag. Bob tries to make him stick on the other side of the board, goes a little bit deeper than I wanted, than he wanted to for that go-around, but he still has a two working. Nothing wrong with that. And Craig misses this weight. Now that is a very good break for Bob. Gives him a chance to get right back in this game. That's a nice cover. Stays right over to the left side of the table, Bob's left. And Craig can either try to stick that two or go for the combo. Either way, he has to hit that two. And Bob's block worked on him. So Bob has two working, he's lagging here. Getting ready to put a nice deep one in there and get himself back in the game if he can. Two or three would be perfect. Looks like he's going to use his free hand to lag. Oh no, he's going back to the rail. Craig's sweating it out here. He knows Bob's dangerous. Big fat three. And now Bob puts one up there, tight against the rail. That's a tough one to wrap. Almost, it's impossible to wrap that weight. Craig's just gonna stick that right up. And it looks like he accidentally bumped him up. I do not think that was on purpose. Could be wrong, but that might have been a mistake for Craig. He's shaking his head, I think. Bob's going to try to cover it wide. So Craig either has to try to combo his own into Bob. Double stick, they call that. Can he make that double stick? It's Bob's cover weight. He's going to try that one more time. Get a nice cover on it. Bob's working with two here without the hammer on. He's got two on the board, and that's a good position to be in. When you're playing defense and you got two working, you're doing something right. Now that came out a little bit on Bob and left that double stick a little bit more wide open for Craig to try. Craig just takes his time here and lines it up. He might be back in this frame. There it goes. Beautiful double stick. Wow. That's as good as it gets. Now Bob's got himself into a little bit of a mess here. Great shot. Picks that right out of there. Craig's thinking hard here, getting ready to lag. Score is 9-8. Craig throws his lag. Can he get one in? Gets one in there. 2 points. Score is 11-9 now. Craig White. These guys are just keeping playing short. Not letting the other guy get a feel for the end of the board. Now Bob Perry keeps the board clean. And a lot of left hand play here from both players. Still keeping the board clean. At this point in the game, the more weight's on the board, oftentimes it can be more dangerous for both sides, actually. It's pretty advantageous if you can continually keep the board clear when you're looking at 11-9 or 12-9. Because if they have one on the table, say you're facing a guy who's on 12 and they have one on the table, then all they have to do is lag a 2. And they're out of the game. And you've seen it. These guys can put up 2s and 3s left and right. Now we're coming down to Bob's lag here. He's going to take his time. Make sure that he gets a feel for it. Make sure he's ready to shoot. Make sure these rails are nice and waxed for him. And the shot. Oh, and he lags off. And that puts us at 12-9. Craig White has 12, Bob Perry has 9 points. This is Bob Perry's hammer. Bob Perry has the last weight on this one. And Craig just keeps playing him short. These guys, once they get on a strategy, they just stick right to it, I guess. It's been working for him, so I don't see why he'd switch it up. Bob just knocks him off to the side. Bob's trying to score 3 points on this frame here to keep himself in the game. And he can do that with one weight, last weight. He just wants to keep the board clean and lag at this point. No nonsense. Oh, maybe. I don't know the game as well as I think I do. So Bob goes around there, creates a little interference for himself. And Craig misses. Wow. Look at that. Just when you think you know what's going on there, you get surprised. So Craig misses. Bob's got one working. What's he gonna do here? Cover it up. Go past it. He doesn't know. He's thinking about it right now. He's waiting for Eddie Brayman to get out of his way there. Eddie's playing a game on the board right next door, and sure, they're experiencing as much drama as Bob and Craig are at this moment. So Bob covers up this weight, leaving Craig with a long combo, difficult shot. Or potentially a go-around if he has that alley. Maybe that might be open free-handed or with a span shot. Looks like he's going for the combo. Only hits the front one. He wanted that. That's a tough shot. And looks like this is Bob's last weight, his hammer weight. And now Bob's again in this situation. Over and over again, you see Bob Perry lagging with one of his own on the board. Very, very good at getting that, getting himself into that situation. Preps his shot. He's going to do a left-handed lag here. And he needs a big one. He needs a 2 or a 3. Oh, man, and he did it. Nice big 3 there for Bob Perry. And that puts Bob Perry at 13. Craig White at 12. And these guys are really fighting it out here. Sticking with the short game. Unrelenting. Wait for wait. Craig's got to think about it here. Sticks him right back. Now Craig's in a great position here, being on 12 points. He can close the game out with his hammer, with just a lag and a three. Maybe get 1 point working. That's what he's trying to do with that one. That's his one, and then all he needs to do is lag a two. So if Bob misses this one or doesn't play it correctly, he can get into trouble here. And I think he's going to try to stick it, but I could be wrong. Wouldn't be the first time I was wrong. Wow, he misses it. That's a miss by Bob Perry. Craig's got 1 point on the board. I think he's going to try to maybe wrap it or bump it. I think he might try to wrap it. I've seen him put some real nice go-arounds on the table. He's certainly capable of it. He only needs three to win here. Three to win the game. He's got one working right now. He's setting up for a right-handed shot. Looks like he's going to go around it. And he does. Just about 10 inches behind the other weight. And that's perfect. Perfect go around in this situation. Now Bob can go around these two if he wants to. Put a nice big one deeper. Hopefully deep enough that Craig cannot hit it. What does he do? He's going around. And he puts a three up. I don't know how covered that is, though. It seems to me that there's plenty of room for Craig to come in and stick that for the win. That's what he's going to try to do here. Span shot. Sends it over. And the weight breaks. Oh, not enough. Didn't stick it. Craig is now on 14. Scores 14-13. Bob Perry has an opportunity to win the game here. Craig throws his first one off intentionally. Doesn't want to give Bob any opportunities to win. Bob sets him up where Craig can stick it. If he sticks it accidentally, Bob will go around it. Ooh, he did stick it. That was an accident. Craig wanted to hit that on the side. Bob's going for the pass. Off the side of the board. Now Craig's on 14, so that represents game on the board for Craig White. Bob has a hammer, so we can get himself out of this mess if he plays well. Craig throws up a short cover. Now Bob needs to throw a firm one up the rail to get the deep one. Potentially hit that go around if it's still open. And he knocks off that deep one. Now Craig's got game on the board. He's going to try to give Bob a real deep, like a light deuce would be perfect. Light two. I think he would have liked it a little deeper, but Bob's still lagging against game on the board. Bob has to keep it on, and he has to get it past that deeper one. And sticking up for 1 point is not an option here, so Bob's really only working with about the last 3 feet of that table there, 2.5, 3 feet of that table. And it's just not a lot of room. What can he do here? Looks like he's choosing a right-handed shot up the rail. Goes to the high side of the weight block and going past it. Oh, and he lags off. And like gentlemen, they shake hands. That was a good game. Tough fought. Final score, 15-13. Craig White wins the game.